வாட்ஸ்அப் வெப் இந்த லேப்டாப் லாகின். தட் இஸ் இன் யுவர் பிசி சார். இட் வில் கெட் கனெக்ட். இஃப் யூ இன்ஸ்டால் தட் வாட்ஸ்அப் வெப் ஆஃப்டர் திஸ் திங் இட் வில் ஆஸ்க் சம் கியூஆர் ஸ்கேன் கோட். தென் இட் வில் கனெக்ட் டு பிசி. டைரக்ட்லி இந்த பிசி யூ கேன் ஓப்பன் டைரக்ட்லி வாட்ஸ்அப். நோ சார், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இந்த லேப்டாப் ஆர் பிசி இன்ஸ்டால் தட் வாட்ஸ்அப். ஆஃப்டர் இன்ஸ்டாலிங்னா யூ கனெக்ட் யுவர் மொபைல் டு தட் பிசி. ஸோ ஆல் த வாட் எவர் கான்டென்ட் இந்த வாட்ஸ்அப்னா தட் வில் கெட் ஓப்பன் இன் யுவர் லேப்டாப். ஸோ தட் யூ கேன் கிளிக் ஆன் த லிங்க்னா இட் வில் கெட் ஓப்பன் டைரக்ட்லி. చేస్తే వస్తాయి మేడం. ఇప్పుడు ఫోన్ ఇట్లా ఇక్కడ ఫోన్ కనిపిస్తుందా నీకు? ఫోన్ సింబల్, ఫోన్ సింబల్ కనిపిస్తుందా? అట్లా ఫోన్ తలాగినా అట్లా సింబల్ కనిపిస్తుంది ఇక్కడ. మళ్ళా వస్తాను మీరు వస్తారా? నేను ఇప్పుడు మీరు గ్లోవ్ చేస్తారు
తిట్టలే తిట్టలేదా ఫోటో ఉంటారు
అదే ఈ కారు అటు కొంత వాకింగ్ చేస్తాం.
Hello, it's I'm Dr. Shanmugapriya.
Yes, madam.
Yeah, I'm going to be the presenter for you. Am I audible?
Okay.
Good morning, madam.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah,
you are audible.
Am I audible? Yeah. Shall we start the class or shall we start others to join it?
Shall we start?
Shall we start the class?
Yes, madam. Good morning, madam.
Good morning. Good morning.
ఏం చెప్తుందమ్మా?
మీటింగ్ కాకుండా
सभी लोग अपना माइक म्यूट कर दे प्लीज प्लीज सब लोग माइक म्यूट कर दे.
So that's I think the slides are visible. So shall we start the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. So good morning again. I'm Dr. Chandrakapriya. I'm a senior DMO from Lalaguda Hospital. I'm basically an ENT surgeon. I'm here to present the topic on first aid. I think there are some disturbances. People, please mute your so that I'll be audible better. Okay. Yes. So what is first aid? So people know first aid is a immediate to a person who is in danger before the arrival of the or before the person reaches the hospital. That is called first aid. So what are the aims of first aid? First aid kyun karna hai? Why should we do first aid? So the first and foremost aim is to preserve the life. You are going to give back the person his one and only precious life. Second aim is to prevent the worsening of the condition. Worsening of the condition matlab kya hai? Suppose a person has got his finger or a hand cut, and if you give first aid in the proper measure, in the proper time, in the proper way, you are going back to give the finger or the hand to the person. This is the second aim of the giving the first aid. That is to prevent the worsening of the condition. Last aim is to promote recovery. That is to make the person go back to the daily activities. So these are the aims of giving first aid. So first we saw what is first aid, and second, what are the aims of giving first aid. So next we will see when we should give first aid. So when should we give first aid? See, for the first few slides, the first aid will be on giving something called CPR. That means the person's heart and lungs are not working. He is almost about to die. Ab jo bhi kar rahe ho, that comes under CPR. Means you are going back to give the life back to the person. So when you should do this? Number one, there is lack of breathing or heartbeat. Kaise malum hota hai person is breathing or not? So you can keep the back of your hand in front of the nose and you have to check for the airflow. That is one way. Second way is you make the person lie down. The person is lying down, you see the movement of the chest up and down. That also means a person is breathing. So when you don't feel the airflow, second, when you don't watch for the movement of the chest up and down, that means that person is not breathing. Second, when there is, how you will check the heartbeat when there is no heartbeat? How will you check the heartbeat? The heart pumps, we all know the heart is a pumping organ. It pumps blood to different parts of the body. So when the heart pumps, that pulse is reflected as the pulse in the wrist. So how will you check the pulse? Are you able to see? This is the thumb. Below the thumb, you insert your middle three fingers and press it. You all can feel for yourself. This is how you check for the pulse or heartbeat. Okay. So in case you don't feel it here, what is the next step? You have to check in the neck. So this is called the groove of the neck. So again, you put middle three fingers in the groove of the neck and give a pressure. You all can feel for yourself. I'll give you 30 seconds. So this is the way how you can feel for the neck pulse. If you don't feel it here, go check and feel the neck pulse. One precaution is don't palpate both the sides same time. So what will happen? These are nothing but blood vessels. Blood vessels are nothing but tube-like structures which carry blood from the heart. What is there in the up? So it is in the goes. It takes the blood to the brain. So when you start pressing both the sides at the same time, the blood will not reach the brain. And the patient may feel giddy and he may even faint. So this is how you have to check for the neck pulse, only one side at a time. Okay. So you cannot keep on checking for a long time. So you have some time. So you check for the breathing for 5 to 10 seconds and heartbeat again for 5 to 10 seconds. If you are not able to feel both, that means the patient is, the person is not having signs of life. That means he's almost about, he is dead or about to die. So this is a condition when you will step into and give the CPR. Other indications are, the second indication, as you see, the severe bleeding and a state of unconsciousness. Unconsciousness is nothing but coma. So these are the other indications where a person requires immediate emergency help. So before going to CPR, we will see what is ABC. ABC rule is A for airway. Airway should be open. Airway means the way to the air, right from the nose or the mouth till the air reaches the lungs. That is the airway. So A for airway, B for breathing. The breathing should be adequate, and C for circulation. All these three should be achieved before giving a CPR. Want you to just go through the right side pictures which you see. Later you can even see the whatever the written literature. So just see the picture, follow the pictures. So the person who gives the first aid is called the, he's the person who gives the first aid. The person who lies down there is nothing but the call, he's called the casualty or victim. So when a person is lying down without any movement, that means he is not showing signs of life. So what will you do immediately? Yeah, you go check for the breathing. This is one way of breathing, but I don't want to, as I told you, you check for the breathing from the back of your hand or the chest up and down. So that is the way how you will check for the breathing. And second, you check for the heartbeat again in the neck pulse. So you check for the breathing, you check for the heartbeat. Hardly up to 15 to 20 seconds, you will come to know whether a person is having signs of life or not. Okay? Yes. If you don't show signs of life, then you start CPR. So as I told, the breathing is done by which organ? It is the lungs. Lungs are the breathing organ. The heartbeat, heart. So you know that there are two organs which are not working in a dead patient. It's heart, one is lungs. So by giving CPR, you have components of CPR. One is chest compression. This is compression. This does the function of the, we all know heart is a pumping organ. So it doesn't pump in a person who is already dead. So just see the picture. The person who should kneel by the side of the person, and the person should be on a lying down position. He should be on a firm ground or table. He should not be put on a sofa or a couch where the person goes up and down. It should be on a firm surface, and the person who gives kneel by the side of the person, and this is called the heel of the palm. So one hand over the other. The fingers to be interlocked. Is it clear? Yeah. Then you have to keep your elbows straight. You have to keep the elbow straight, and you have to push it from the shoulders. So this is how you should give it. So you should give it from the shoulders. You should never bend the elbows, like as you see in this picture. So where you have to give the chest compression, for that you should know where is heart located. So that the heart is in the left side. That is what the answer when usually I get when I take a class. So you all think on the left side. Actually it is in the center of the chest. Because on both the sides, what right and left side of the heart, you have right and left lungs. So you have two lungs. The heart has to be in the center, and there are both the lungs on either side of it. So why it's important? You should know where you should give the chest compression. Okay. So how you give it? You should just press it in such a way that inside by 1.5 to 2 inches, roughly. You cannot calculate it, but the thing is, the position and the technique which I told you, if you adapt it, you will not have more prashtanas required. Okay, so how fast you have to give? For example, for 1 minute, that is up to 60 seconds, you can give up to even 80, 60 to 80 or even 100 compressions. So it is like it's a bit faster than your second. For 60 seconds, you give 80 compressions. So next we will go to the second. Before that, see, for a small child like this, you need not have to give whole pressure as I told before, the previous slide which you saw. Just with the compression with the two fingers like this, or just with one palm like this, it is sufficient. Because if you give so much of pressure than is required, it may even fracture the ribs of the child. So the next second thing is, the first component of CPR is chest compression. Second component is mouth-to-mouth ventilation. As you see here, the person does not breathe. His lungs are not working. So you have to give it by external or artificial means. For this, the position of the head is very, very important. I'll go back to this picture. I think my arrow points it here. Yes. So you have to extend the head, lift the chin with one hand, support the forehand, and close the nostrils with both your thumb and close the nostrils, and automatically the mouth opens and you can or mouth, and you can blow mouth. Okay, but before this, I wanted to remind you that going to give a first aid to a person whose infectivity status is not known. Means what is the meaning? You are giving a first aid to a stranger whose infective status is not known. Matlab, he may have HIV positive patient, or he may be hepatitis B positive. All these infections, these viruses transmit through saliva also. Especially when you are having a small wound or ulcer in your mouth, there is a chance that infection from the victim can transmit to you. So it's always better that you protect yourself by laying a handkerchief or a small cloth, clean cloth over the person's mouth, and then you can start giving the mouth-to-mouth ventilation or the air blows. So what is CPR? I know that CPR is. So what is expansion of CPR? C stands for cardio, P for pulmonary, R for resuscitation. Means cardiopulmonary resuscitation. As I told you, CPR has got two components. These are two components. One is chest compression, that does the function of the heart. Second is mouth-to-mouth ventilation, which does the function of the lungs. So how do you alternate it? Suppose if this like this picture, if you are only one person who is giving first aid, what do you have to do? You have to give chest compressions 15 times. One at a little speed. As I told you, for 60 seconds, it is 80 compressions. So a bit faster than you have to give compressions, but you have to count it by your mind. Give 15 compressions. Go to the head and give mouth-to-mouth ventilation 2 times. Compression and mouth-to-mouth breathing or artificial ventilation is 15 is giving first aid. Suppose you see this picture in two persons. There is one person who is giving first aid, and there is also another person who is also helping him. You can one person can stay near the chest and can give chest compression, head in, and he can give the mouth-to-mouth ventilation, and you can alternate also. So in that case, the ratio is between 5:1. So you give 5 compressions, 5 chest compressions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you ask your friend or the other person who is giving mouth-to-mouth ventilation to give 1. So here the ratio is between 5:1. If you are only one person who is giving first aid, the ratio of chest compression to mouth-to-mouth ventilation is 15:2. So if your two persons are giving, 5:1. So these are absolute values. You have to keep it by your heart. Just take it in the last. Probably we'll be having a break in between. So after in the break session, before the break session also, you can have some 5 minutes to the whatever the doubts you can note down the doubts, and you can either post me or you can your through your mic. How you check the neck pulse? Mouth to mouth resuscitation. Yeah, this is how you give the chest compression. This the basic of CPR, that is a cardiopulmonary resuscitation is over. Note it down and you can ask at the end of the class or in between before we go for the break or immediately after the break. So next we will see the in slide for heart attack. So for heart, if a person has heart attack, what is the first? So first of all, what is heart attack? Heart attack, we all know, obstruction or block in the blood supply to the heart. We all know heart is a pumping organ and it pumps blood to different parts of the body. For that, heart also requires some blood. When the blood supply to the heart is affected, we call it as heart attack. So what are the symptoms of heart attack? What are the clinical features? What they say when the person has heart attack, what all they complain? So you all know, first and foremost is chest pain. So the chest pain will be like, it will be almost like a severe pain the jaw, left shoulder, upper back also it can radiate. So these are the eight attack can radiate or it can go. Left shoulder and left arm, because the heart structure of the heart, structure of the heart, it is tilted towards the left like this. So the reflected towards the left side. So apart of heart attack, what are the other feel? Which is a profuse sweating, and he can have breathlessness. He will say that I am able to breathe properly. Okay, sometimes a person can also have giddiness. So these are the other symptoms of heart attack. So suppose you have gone to a camp or where you have gone for a separate class or something. You have a first aid box, and your colleague or somebody develops a heart attack. The symptoms of heart attack, and you think it is heart attack. What's the immediate first aid you give it to him? I told you there is a first aid box. So for all first aid box, we having some medicines. So you will open the box and take the medicine which you give. I think you all know the answer. That is aspirin. Aspirin or dispirin, both. You can just take one tablet of aspirin, 325 milligrams of strength. A cheaper medicine, but it can save the life of a person, and it really does wonder what it does. Blood thinner, so it lyses the clot, I mean loosens the clot, so the blood flow is again restored. So just ask the person to swallow one tablet of aspirin, 325 milligrams, with a glass of water. That will help in decreasing the, and that will provide him like some amount of rescue person to reach the hospital, and the total treatment can be started. So just give him one tablet of aspirin and ask him to go to the hospital immediately. You take him either through ambulance, you can call the ambulance, or you can make him comfortably seated like this. So he wheeler, because at all will put a stress on the heart. So this is an ideal position. This is called semi prone position, in the 45 degrees reclined position, not totally flat. It's a person to totally lie down when a person has got chest pain. So what will happen? All heart. So this is the ideal position when you shift a person suspected to have heart attack due to the hospital. So what is cardiac arrest? So what is the difference between heart attack and arrest? What happens? Hindi mein bhi bolna padega? Theek, right. क्योंकि ये पूरा थोड़ा इंग्लिश वर्ड ही आता है ना, फिर भी आपको जो भी डाउट है थोड़ा मिक्स करके बोलना है, ठीक है, राइट। मेरा हिंदी तो इतना साफ नहीं है, आप थोड़ा एडजस्ट करना पड़ेगा, राइट। क्या है So in cardiac arrest, the heart suddenly stops working. मतलब the heart एकदम stop हो जाएगा. So why it happens? होना है. So because of the massive heart attack. When heart attack is so serious or severe, a cardiac arrest आता है. So cardiac arrest में क्या होता है? The person will not tell I am having chest pain. Okay, वो कुछ भी बोलने के भी time नहीं होगा है. So what happens is the person has suddenly feels giddy or suddenly collapses on the ground. You would have seen people suddenly falling on the ground and totally the life stops. That may be because of cardiac arrest. वो कुछ नहीं बोलता है, वो pain है, कुछ नहीं बोलने के लिए chance नहीं है. Suddenly the person collapses. This is called cardiac arrest. This is what happened to our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. क्या हुआ? He was taking a class, he was giving a lecture. All of a sudden, he developed cardiac arrest. He collapsed in the class itself, and nobody knew what has happened. But this is called cardiac arrest. So, cardiac arrest mein kya karna hai? So, what is the treatment you will do in cardiac arrest? What first aid treatment you will do? You should not give anything by mouth. This is the first dictum or first treatment. Treatment wise, kuch bhi nahi dena hai muh se. Kyun? Because a person is unconscious. Whatever you put it in the mouth will go into the have chance to go into the lungs. He will aspirate and you are doing more danger. Isliye muh se kuch bhi nahi dena hai. I told you cardiac arrest, the person is unconscious, wo breathing nahi hai, heartbeat nahi hai. So you have to immediately start giving CPR. Kuch bhi nahi karna hai. Immediately start resuscitation. Resuscitation matlab CPR start karna hai. And you have to give a call to the hospital for ambulance. Immediately patient ko shift karna hai. So this is the only treatment which you have to give for cardiac arrest. No medicine to be given by mouth. A second emergency hai. In this emergency, aap, what is coming to your mind? See, he is almost catching hold of the throat. इमरजेंसी है जो भी आप आम खा रहे हैं इट शुड गो इन टू द फूड पाइप इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग टू द फूड पाइप इफ दैट समथिंग दैट बोलर्स और वॉट एवर गोज इन टू द विंड पाइप दिस इज कॉल्ड चोकिंग विंड पाइप एक्सेप्ट फॉर एयर नथिंग शुड गो बट वेन द फूड पार्टिकल गोज इन टू द विंड पाइप इट इज कॉल्ड चोकिंग और नॉर्मली ये नहीं होना है बट बिकॉज वी हैव गुड कॉफ मैकेनिज्म आप जो भी थोड़ा एस्पिरेट कर रहे हैं इमीडिएटली कॉफ करते हैं एंड द फॉरेन बॉडी विल कम आउट बट एन अ पर्सन इज हेवीली बूस्ड मीन्स ही हैज टेकन सो मच ऑफ अल्कोहल एंड ही ट्राइज टू ईट अ बिग पीस ऑफ फूड से चिकन और मटन बोलस इट हैज अ चांस टू गो इन टू द विंड पाइप इंस्टेड ऑफ फूड पाइप सो दैट इज कॉल्ड चोकिंग सो इस कंडीशन में क्या करना है Nothing, no treatment, again, no medicine can save him. Only this maneuver. You can see this is Heimlich maneuver. So anything you do with your hands is called maneuver. So you go stand behind the person like this and make a fist with one hand and the other hand you just fold it like this and put it and just keep it in the upper part of the abdomen. That is in this area. Don't give it to the chest. It should be in the abdomen, as you see in this picture. You put your all your pressure in the abdomen and give upward and backward pressure. So upward and backward. So what happens? क्या होता है? ये pressure build up होता है chest cavity में, and that foreign body, whichever is in the windpipe, will get pushed out. So this is the only treatment or maneuver which you can do to save his life. वो इतना जल्दी करना है अगर आप 5 to 10 minutes में नहीं कर पाते हो तो द पर्सन में इवन डाई ही में बिकम ब्लू ऑल ओवर एंड ही में डाई सो दिस शुड बी डन इमीडिएटली व्हेन यू थिंक द पर्सन इज चोकिंग ओके फॉर अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड लाइक दिस सो एज यू सी यू कैन जस्ट विद अ चाइल्ड सपोज अ चाइल्ड इज प्लेइंग विद अ स्मॉल टॉय और अ स्मॉल कॉइन एंड इट हैज गॉन इन टू द विंड पाइप एंड द चाइल्ड इज coughing heavily and is becoming gasping and it is difficult to breathing is condition mein kya karna hai you know that the foreign body has gone into the windpipe so immediately put the child upside down thoda pat karna hai back pe so again this builds up the pressure and because of the effect of gravity the foreign body आ जाते हैं। The person is person बेहोश पे नहीं है। सडनली पर्सन इज अनकॉन्शियस बट ही है, वो नॉर्मल है लेकिन वो रेस्पॉन्स नहीं। व्हाट आर द रीजंस दैट द पर्सन हैज बिकम अनकॉन्शियस? इट कुड द कॉमन रीजंस आर ब्लड प्रेशर, शुगर, दीज टू आर वेरी कॉमन। सो एस्पेशली अबव इधर हाई बीपी और लो बीपी। सो यू आपके साथ कुछ ऑटोमेटिक बीपी मशीन है तो आप चेक कर सकते हैं, नहीं तो यू हैव टू चेक योर शुगर। शुगर कैसे चेक करेंगे? यू हैव अ ग्लूकोमीटर। अगेन इफ यू आर हैविंग अ स्मॉल ग्लूकोमीटर यू कैन चेक द ब्लड शुगर लेवल्स। अगेन हाई ब्लड शुगर और वेरी लो ब्लड शुगर कैन ऑल्सो कॉज को सो ट्रीटमेंट ट्रीटमेंट the underlying cause of coma. Matlab if the person is having low sugar and the person is not conscious, don't give sugar water. And the person is saying I'm having giddiness and you check the blood sugar, his 60 or 50, then you think it is a low sugar and the person give sugar water. Sugar water kaisa karna hai? Just put sugar pani se kuch batar milke, ask him to drink half glass of sugar water, or you can give some chocolates also. But the person is totally unconscious, don't give anything again by mouth. This is my take home message. अगर पेशेंट कॉन्शियस नहीं है तो कुछ भी मुंह से नहीं देना है। सो व्हाट एवर यू गिव इट विल गो इनटू द लंग्स इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग इनटू द स्टमक। अदर कॉजेज ऑफ कोमा, व्हाट आर द अदर कॉजेज विच कैन कॉज कोमा? नेक्स्ट थिंग इज एक्सीडेंट एंड हेड इंजुरी। सो रोड ट्रैफिक एक्सीडेंट विच कैन कॉज हेड इंजुरी, द पर्सन कैन बिकम अनकॉन्शियस। अनकॉन्शियस होने से आपको यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल दैट समथिंग वुड हैव हैपेंड टू द ब्रेन। सो ब्रेन इंजुरी कुछ होने के चांसेस है, इसीलिए सीटी स्कैन जरूर निकालना पड़ेगा। सो अगेन द ट्रीटमेंट डिपेंड्स ऑन द अंडरलाइंग कॉज ऑफ कोमा। कोमा के लिए पूरा ट्रीटमेंट एक ही नहीं है। सो यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द रीजन फॉर कोमा एंड यू हैव टू स्टार्ट योर इमीडिएट ट्रीटमेंट। इमीडिएटली बेटर टू गिव शिफ्ट द पर्सन टू द एम्बुलेंस हॉस्पिटल। एंड अगेन वन मोर रीजन फॉर अनकॉन्शियसनेस इज पर्सन इज हैविंग फिट्स आफ्टर फिट्स और सीजर्स। फिट्स से तो क्या है, दे थ्रो फिट्स। आई थिंक मेनी ऑफ यू वुड हैव सीन आल्सो व्हाट हाउ द फिट्स अपीयर। सो दिस इज अनदर कॉज ऑफ कोमा। द फिट्स का ट्रीटमेंट अलग से है, आई विल शो इन द अदर स्लाइड। सो दिस इज अ पिक जस्ट शो अबव 60 इयर्स ही मे यूज समथिंग कॉल्ड डेंचर्स। डेंचर्स से तो क्या है, समटाइम्स इट इज फिक्स्ड और समटाइम्स इट कैन बी रिमूवेबल आल्सो। जो भी करना पड़ेगा बिफोर यू स्टार्ट गिविंग माउथ टू माउथ वेंटिलेशन। क्यों? सपोज द डेंचर इज वेरी लूज, दैट इट्सेल्फ बिकम अ फॉरन व्हेन यू ब्लो एयर इनटू द माउथ। सो आप देखना पड़ेगा अगर कुछ डेंचर कुछ है, देखना पड़ेगा कुछ डेंचर है क्या, लूज टीथ कुछ है क्या, वो आर्टिफिशियल टीथ कुछ है क्या, वो रिमूव करके फिर आप देना पड़ेगा, नहीं तो दैट इट्सेल्फ विल बिकम अ फॉरन। The different organs of which emergency we have seen. Next we'll move on to the injuries. आपको अगर 10 मिनट के बाद I will give you some break. So we will break by 9:45. Who is the rep of this class?
Yes, no, I am hosting the class.
Mr. Rajesh Kumar?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
अच्छा, आप ब्रेक कब देना है?
10 मिनट बाद ना, 5 मिनट का ब्रेक होता है अभी।
अच्छा, 9:30 को होना है, 9:45 को?
अब तो हम लोग 9:45 में करते हैं।
मैं 9:45 में करेंगे, ठीक है, राइट। सो आई विल जस्ट प्रोसीड विद माय क्लासेस। सो स्लाइड्स है तो नेक्स्ट स्लाइड इज लाइक इंजुरीज। सो इंजुरीज में हाउ विल यू डील विथ इंजुरीज? इंजुरीज का है तो एज यू सी हियर देर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ इंजुरीज। दिस इज द सिंपल वूंड एंड लॉस ऑफ मोबिलिटी इज अ फ्रैक्चर। नंबर 8 इज अ फ्रैक्चर एंड नंबर 2 इज hemorrhage is like a severe bleeding. I don't know why these numbers are put and these are the already preformed slides. And the next one is a burns. So is आपको वो ट्रायंगुलर रेड ट्रायंगुलर का है वो रेड ट्रायंगुलर साइन मींस इट इज अ डेंजर सिंबल और डेंजर साइन सो एज यू सी हियर बर्न्स एंड हेमरेज सिवियर ब्लीडिंग तो सिवियर ब्लीडिंग एंड बर्न्स इंजरीज आर डेंजरस इंजरीज सिंपल वुंड एंड फ्रैक्चर दीज आर नॉट डेंजरस टू द लाइफ ऑफ कोर्स दे मे बी कॉजिंग सम पेन एंड डिफिकल्टी टू द पर्सन But they are not, they don't endanger the life of the person. Life ka aage to kuch problem nahi hoga. Lekin hemorrhage, severe bleeding and burns may even make the person die. So aap, we can see one by one. Wound is nothing but a break in the skin. There are different types of wound. This is called incised wound. This is like a... आप ये थोड़ा द इंजुरी इज मेड विद अ शार्प फॉर अ ब्लेड विच हैज अ शार्प कट इन द स्किन इज वुंड एंड द सेकेंड वन इज कॉल्ड द लैसरेशन लैसरेशन दिस हैपेंस व्हेन यू फॉल डाउन लाइक व्हेन यू एन इरेगुलर इंजुरी इज कॉल्ड अ लैसरेशन हियर द नेक्स्ट वन इज एज यू सी हियर When you fall and you're just dragged along, the skin gets rubbed off. This is called abrasion. This is otherwise called as next is contusion. बोलते हैं हम. So in this the skin is intact. Skin है तो overlying skin is intact. Of blood under the skin, and that's why you. So clear. So this is the contusion or bruise. So next. Next one is puncture wound. So, what is with a sharp piercing instrument, say nail, this puncture wounds. Last is a gunshot wound. As you see here, gunshot wounds are medico legal cases. So, आपको जो gunshot wound में आप you have to look for the entry wound and exit wound. So, the bullet comes. Tries to exit the body. So when the bullet there is no exit wound, then what does it mean? Agar exit wound nahi hai, toh what do you understand? The bullet is inside the body. In that case, we have to take an X-ray to locate where the bullet is, and the doctor does an operation to remove the bullet. Okay. So when you see the exit wound, entry wound, exit wound, dono hai toh you have to search for the bullet. Below and you have to take the bullet put it in a cover along with the person along the giving the first aid you have to take the bullet also because all these are matters of in the court of law as I told you the all gunshot wound injuries are medico legal cases be it either accidental or homicidal like kya hai murder karne ke liye kuch dusra ke kuch hurt karne ke liye karne to that is comes under homicidal If accidentally it comes, suppose an RPF trainee hai, when he was involved in training, suddenly he triggers the bullet. In that case also, it has to be made under medical legal case. So what is the treatment for all these wounds? So, what is the treatment for all these ones? First and foremost, what will you do? Whenever you have a wound, you have to clean the wound properly. Cleaning is the first and foremost step. So, cleaning the wound, matlab, you have to wash the wound with running water and soap. You have to apply soap and clean the wound properly. Because when the skin is a protective barrier to us, when the skin is lost, you have the chance of getting infection. बाहर जो भी जर्म्स है दे हैव द चांस टू गेट इनटू द बॉडी इसीलिए आप जो भी वुंड है तो अच्छी तरफ यू हैव टू वॉश द वुंड विद रनिंग वाटर एंड सोप दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप सेकंड इफ यू हैव वुंड लाइक दिस व्हेन देयर इज लिटिल बिट ऑफ ब्लीडिंग इज आल्सो देयर सो यू हैव टू अप्लाई समथिंग कॉल्ड गौज पीस तो यू शुड नॉट अप्लाई कॉटन शुड नेवर बी you have something called gauze piece. I don't know whether the picture is there here. You, it's like a square piece with a netted piece of cloth. So it is not a cotton directly on wound. So what will happen? Cotton apply karay to, the fibers will stick. Be very difficult to remove the cotton fibers. So apply something like a gauze piece, which is like a piece of cloth with a netted pattern that you can apply, and with the antiseptic. So antiseptic solution, जो भी आपके पास आपके साथ है, like either Dettol or Savlon or ना कुछ भी नहीं तो even spirit भी apply कर सकते. So clean the wound with that antiseptic solution or apply some antiseptic solution on the gauze piece and keep it on the wound and tie, make a tie around the wound. So that will stop the bleeding. And you ask the person to go to the hospital. So हम क्या करेंगे after the person reaches hospital, all types of wound will be given. What injection to prevent infection? We give yes, tetanus toxoid, TT. TT stands for tetanus toxoid. Tetanus injection dete hai. It's a vaccine to prevent the infection of tetanus. And the doctor open karke dekhte hai. Agar waisa incised wound jada deep wound hai, then we will put some sutures karenge. Again we'll put the dressing back and we will give some antibiotics and painkillers. Next is hemorrhage or severe bleeding. Severe bleeding, the person will become low blood pressure and he may lose so much of blood and may die. So kya karna hai? You have to control the bleeding. Aap kaise control kar? You have to apply pressure. So when you apply pressure, what the clotting factors come and the blood clots in that area. So you will not have any bleeding further. So kaisa karenge, you have to apply something called gauze pad. Jyada big cloth kuch bhi nahi hai to achhi nice clean cloth, but should be a thicker cloth. So you can apply over here on it and you have to elevate the part. Thoda wo part ko elevate, it will prevent the bleeding and it, because of the effect of gravity, it will allow the blood to go into the vital parts, the upper part of the body, like this. So that principles of controlling the hemorrhage: one is compression, second is elevation. ये दोनों आप याद रखना है, okay? And the person will be having so much of pain also. So pain कम होने के लिए क्या करेंगे? You have to give some painkiller. What is the best painkiller you give? Safest is, I don't want you to give any Oviron, Brufen, nahi dena hai. Kyunki there are chances that the person can have allergy to these medicines and the person can even die because of giving that medicine. So paracetamol is safest. Paracetamol 500 milligrams or 650 milligrams, you can give the person safely.
इधर ना हाँ दस इंच है यार, जिससे वायर जो है ना वो एकदम ठीक सेटिंग करके सीधा दस इंच उधर किनारे पांच है ना कुछ देर वो पांचे रहेगा बाकी इस बार जहाँ तक जोड़ा हुआ बैठा है बेस.
अरे हाँ भाई अपना माइक म्यूट कर लीजिए, माइक म्यूट कर लीजिए जो बात कर बीके सिंह जी.
बीके सिंह माइक म्यूट करना. राजेश मेरे को होस्ट बना दे नर्स मैम को.
ओके सर.
So painkiller में क्या देना है? You should give paracetamol. It is available in 500 milligrams or 650 milligrams. One tablet of paracetamol can be given to decrease the pain. For fever, लेकिन paracetamol को तो pain killing property भी है. So and it is the safest tablet. So it's always better that you give one tablet of paracetamol for pain relief. Don't give Brufen or Oviron or Aciclofenac or whatever the painkiller. So like this, suppose a person has hand, you put some nice pressure bandage and tie it part above the level of the heart, above the gravity. So nose bleeding mein kya hota hai? Shall we break now? Rajesh Kumar?
Sir, two class. Ma'am, two class hai, 9 to 10 and 10:15 to 11:15.
अच्छा ना 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 नहीं नहीं ला
ग्यारह बजे का हॉस्पिटल 9 to 10 मैम आफ्टर 10 वी कैन टेक इट फर्स्ट क्लास इज ऑन 9 to 10
आफ्टर 10
यस
10:15 to 11:15 15 मिनट ब्रेक
पापा आफ्टर 10 टू 15
लेना है नहीं नहीं लाइक 11 o'clock मेरा थोड़ा हॉस्पिटल पे काम है सो व्हाट वी विल डू इज विल ब्रेक नाउ 10-15 मिनट्स 10 to 11 तक खत्म करेंगे
राइट
Okay. We'll just break for 9:15 it is. So 10 o'clock we'll assemble back.
ये बेटा हॉर्स कैसे चेंज हो गया सर?
आप ही रहोगे?
हाँ चेंज मेक माय ब्रेंटेस ब्रेंट यहाँ को बनाना चाहते हैं किसी
किसी और को बना दे रहे हो?
हाँ
क्यों?
बना के हटेंगे बनाए ब्रेंटेस ये सब बनाएंगे इसको अच्छा जिसको बनाए उसको पड़ेगा ना एक मिनट नहीं
नहीं
हाँ यस सर तो बना ओके वन मिनट सर
अभी तो वील ब्रेक एंड वील असेंबल बैक एट 10 o'clock
कंटिन्यू करें
सर आपको होस्ट बना दिए हैं सर नसमा सर आपको होस्ट बना दिए हैं
हाँ राइट राइट ओके राजेश
ओके सर
protecting of the face. That is a part which gets hurt first. So that's a commonest part of the face which gets injured in a case of any trauma or accident. So that is again a cause of nosebleed. And next and the most important cause of nosebleed, that is spontaneous without any provoking factor, especially above 40 years. 40 years, 35 or 40 years ka upar, suddenly nosebleed hota hai, toh kya check karna hai? So it could be a high pressure. So immediately the person ko BP check karna hai. Agar high BP ke liye nosebleed ho raha hai, kya dekhna padega. So what is the first aid treatment for nosebleed? Agar bleeding hone ke samay kya karna hai? Stop the bleeding. As I told you in the previous slides, wherever there is bleeding, you have to give compression or pressure to control the bleeding. So nose bleeding ko kaisa compression karenge, kaisa pressure denge, wo control hone ke liye. So again, you have to use your thumb and index finger. Apply pressure on both the nostrils and ask the person to open the mouth and breathe through the mouth. So most of the answers which I get is like nosebleed hone ke liye, you ask the person to lie flat. No, that is wrong. This is the ideal position. Make the person sit and lean forward and compress both the nostrils with the thumb and index finger. First and first two fingers, you hold the nostrils and give pressure. Pressure kab tak dena hai? Approximately 3 to 5 minutes, because that is a normal clotting time. So wo karne se, how will the person breathe? So muh se breathe karna hai. So ask him to open the mouth and slowly breathe through the mouth for another 3 to 5 minutes. So this controls the bleeding for most of the cases. 90 to 95% of the cases will get controlled with this. So clear? And apart from this, you can apply some ice cubes. Ice cubes ko thoda leke thoda kerchief mein thoda baandh ke, you can apply it over the cheeks and the nose. So ice apply karne se kya hota hai? When the blood vessel is like this, so blood vessel is nothing but the tube-like structures which carry blood. Aisa hone se, ice apply karne se, it will become like this. It shrinks. So the lumen becomes small. Isiliye further bleeding nahi hota hai. So these are the main first aid measures for a nosebleed case. And above 35 or 40 years, please ask him to go check the blood pressure. Yes. Before going to fracture, this is a skeleton system showing the human skeleton bones of the bones. As you all know, this is the longest bone. Longest bone is nothing but a thigh bone, which is called femur. The smallest bone is in the, I think most of you will know, it is in the ear. That's called stapes. And total number of bones in our body is 6. Just for a general knowledge. And go to the fracture. As you all know, what is fracture? Fracture is a break in the bone. Wound is break in the skin. You see different types of fractures here. So the first one is simple fracture. So it's a small crack or break in the bone. You can see the break line or the fracture line. Another part is the skin. The skin is intact. There is no problem with the skin. Only the bone got fractured. This is called simple fracture, where the bone is also not displaced and only the small crack. Here you see the bones are displaced. There's a fracture line and two bones are getting displaced like this. Again, here the skin is unbroken. The skin is intact. So these two fractures are called as closed fractures, where the skin is open at all. So they are relatively safe. You see the next fracture, this is open fracture. As the name indicates, open fracture means the skin is also open. And the fractured bone comes out through the skin. Whenever the skin is open, what is the risk? The risk of infection. So the germs will come inside the body when the skin is open. So in this condition, when there is a break in the skin and the fractured bone also gets exposed, that is the risk of fracture, the infection getting into the fractured bone. Agar bone mein infection hua toh, it takes almost months to get healed. You may require months of antibiotics. So it is not an easy thing at all. So aap itna precaution lena padega ye open fracture mein, you have to take utmost precaution. Your hand should be clean and you have to take all hygienic measures. Next fracture is comminuted fracture. As you see, the bone pieces, there are so many pieces of the bone. The bone is almost shattered into so many pieces, which happens in severe injuries. And the last one is a green stick fracture. Green stick fracture, as the name indicates, that when you try to break a drumstick, you will not be able to break it full. So only one part will be broken. Similarly, only this part is broken and this part of the bone is intact. This happens in children and it is also a mild fracture. Only these two things, that is open fracture and comminuted fractures, they are very dangerous and that's very difficult to heal once the infection sets in. And so what is the treatment for fracture? The patient ko hospital lene ke baad orthopedician ko bulana padega. We have to take a x-ray to confirm there is fracture. And doctor, what he does? He applies the something called POP. POP hai toh kya hai? Plaster of Paris. So he applies different, so many layers of plaster of Paris to set the bone right. Okay. So again, these conditions, only we do only a minimal amount of support, but the remaining part is there by the body itself. Agar aisa fracture hone ke samay aap set karke thoda, you have to apply POP and ask a person to not to move, not to use that particular limb for another 2 months, 2 to 3 months, depending on the different limbs. So why bolne se kya hota hai, the bone, new bones forms in this area. So the new bones forms here and the fracture sets in. It gets healed. A wiser condition may, the person may also require some amount of surgery. Okay. So what is it? First aid treatment. Ye to treatment. Doctor jo bhi de rahe hai, wo actual treatment hai. Lekin first aid mein kya, aam ka kya role hai? So again, in all these conditions, you make sure that part does not move while the person is shifted to the hospital. So for you call first aid. Something like the base and the apex. So you have to fold the bandage in such a way. The person has got a fracture in the arm. You put it in such a way that the base appears here and this part of the end, the neck, and you put a knot here. So this acts as a, it's like a jula. So that part of the limb is supported in the sling so that when the person ambulance or through any other vehicle to the hospital, that part should not move. So that is our aim. A different way, so that part, our aim is that to make sure that part does not, the fractured part does not move. Apart from this, again, as I told you, you can give some painkiller like paracetamol to decrease the pain of the person. Yeah. The treatment written literature later. Ways how a person can be shifted from the place of injury to the ambulance or to the, if you are strong enough, you can carry a person like this, as a person, especially when the patient is a bit unconscious, you have to carry him this way. Oh, I wanted you to see this picture, the last picture. As you see, a person is almost tight. A person is put on a stretcher. And he is tied at multiple levels. Here they have tied again in the chest level. Everywhere they have tied. So, what do you think this person has got into? Kya hua hai? So, probably yes, he has got spine. Spine injury mein kya? What is the danger of spine injury? Spine hai to kya hai? It is nothing but backbone. Backbone. It starts from the level of the neck to the place where we all sit. It is a series of thirds, one stalked over the other. Okay. So it is like a one stalked over the other, 33 bones in one line. Why it is important? It carries something called spinal cord. So spinal cord is nothing but bundle of nerves. Agar one person is getting injury to the back, or fractured segment, jo bhi hai, fractured bone, suppose it injures the spinal cord and breaks the nerve, it is going to be a permanent damage. So you have to be very careful when a person is having severe pain in the middle of the back and he says, I'm not able to move, it's very severe. Don't allow him to walk and go, or don't even allow him to sit. Just put him on a straight position like this. Wait for the stretcher to come. Nicely tie him so that he does not have an even minimal movement, and shift him to the ambulance. For example, when a person has got a suspected neck fracture, you give support all around the neck so that part does not move. स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी में क्या होता है, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द लेवल ऑफ इंजरी, अगर नेक में स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी हो गया तो बोथ अपर लिम्स एंड लोअर लिम्स ऑल द फोर लिम्स विल गेट पैरलाइज्ड. ओके, सपोज अ पर्सन एट दिस लेवल, बैक लेवल, बैक लेवल में इंजरी हुआ, स्पाइनल कॉर्ड का इंजरी हो गया, he will have both the lower limbs paralyzed. He will become only wheelchair bound. He cannot walk on his own for the rest of his life. We have a person who is just 30-35 years in our hospital because of some injury. He had a spinal cord injury and following which he comes and goes only by wheelchair. So that is the severity on the of injury of spinal cord. So you have to make sure that when a person has got spine injury, there is every possibility that the person can have spinal cord damage also. So you have to transport him in a proper way without any movement. That is our role in giving first aid to such persons. So next, going on to the burns, as you see in this picture, there are different percentage of burns. Percentage, you know that person has got 20% burns, 50% burns, 80% burns. So what does that percentage mean? 20% to kya hota hai, 50%, 90% kya hota hai? So that indicates the surface of the body, how much of amount of surface of the body the burns is covered with. For example, this is called the rule of 9. Is picture mein aap jo bhi dekh rahe hai, this is called rule of 9. Here the body is divided into 11 areas. Each 9%. So 11 into 9 is 99. Along with one genitals, it is 1% of genitals, it is 100. It comes to 100. So out of 100, suppose a person has got burns, say in his head, upper chest, upper back, one arm. So what is the percentage of burns? I told you four areas. So each 9%. So 9 into 4 is 36%. So the percentage of burns is 36. So this is how they calculate the percentage of burns. So why should we know how much is the percentage of burns? Farak kya hai? Farak kya hota hai? 30% ka, 50% ka, 80% ka farak kya hai? So that will tell us the person whether he will survive or not, whether he will live or not. Agar 70% ka upar hai to the person is going to die for 100% sure. 70% ka burns ka upar hai to he will not live. He may be not talking to you normally after 70% skin pura pura burns ho jayega, fir bhi iska he will be talking normally second day, third day, 1 week tak bhi he will be okay, but at the end of 1 week, say 1 week or 10 days kaisa bhi, he cannot live beyond it. Why? What is the cause of death in a case of burns? Yes, infection. As I told you, the skin is a protective barrier, it's like a strength to us. Agar skin itna 70% ka skin burn ho gaya to there is chance even for mild infection to become severe. Isiliye jo bhi aap antibiotic de rahe hain, wo you give some hospital treatment, whatever the treatment you give, you cannot save the life of a person when there has got more than 70-75% of burns. Is it clear? So less than 50% hai to inka is life is not in danger. 50-70% it can be either way, depending on other factors. A person is diabetes or any other problem he has. So depending on this, depending on his immunity, jo bhi factors hai, different factors are there, so that he can either recover or he can die. So 50-70% hai to either side it can go. So what is the first aid treatment for that person? Suppose a person is almost trying to burn himself, pouring kerosene and trying to commit suicide. So what will you do? If you have enough water, you can pour water and stop the fire. Or if you don't have anything, it's better that you apply something like a blanket, thick blanket or sack, thick sack, woolen cloth, whichever you have, you can apply it and put off the fire. That is the first thing. Nothing is there. You just ask the person to roll on the floor. For a small area like this, only one portion of the hand, only one forearm is burnt. You run the burned area under cool running water and keep a clean dry dressing. Like as I told you, don't apply cotton, apply the gauze piece which I told you before. Apply it over that area, cover the area and raise the burn area above the heart, above the level of the heart of the person, and shift him to the hospital as early as possible. Okay, next we'll go on to the, suppose as I told you in the start of the class, A person's finger or a hand is cut. A person is working in a machine. So accidentally, he put his finger into the machine and the finger is cut and it is lying on the floor. So what will you do? I heard so many answers that you will go take the finger and everything. But before that, attend to the person. He must be bleeding. He will have so much of pain and he is bleeding from the part which has the from which the finger has got cut. So inka pehle treatment dena padega. So you go see the person and apply some bandage to control the bleeding first and again give him some assurance. Inka to itna tension hota hai kyunki his hand or finger got cut and it is lying down. How much of mental stress and pressure he would be having. So aap kuch to kuch achhi words bolke you have to make him comfortable. Boost up his confidence, give him some faith. Don't worry, we are all here. Nothing will happen to you. Kuch kuch achhi words aap bolna padega. Then gives him some painkiller. Of course, he will have pain also. So aapko to thoda paracetamol kuch tablet dena padega and control the bleeding. Ask him to wait. Then you go see the finger. Abhi finger ko kya karenge? You have to take the finger. Don't apply soap because it is lying on the ground. It has got the chance of all the germs on it. So take the finger. Wash it in running water. Don't apply soap and pat it dry. The finger should be nicely pat dry and dry hone ke baad wo gauze piece se cover karke ek plastic cover pe dalna hai. Okay, I think I'll show you the picture. So first step is wash the finger. No soap to be applied. Pat it dry. After the dryness, put a clean gauze and put it in the plastic cover. And this plastic cover with the finger should be put in another cover containing ice cubes. मतलब क्या है? आप जो भी cut finger है, it should not come in direct contact with the ice. So it should be separated. That's why you need two plastic covers. So you have to shift the person along with the cut finger as early as possible to a nearby tertiary care hospital. Don't waste your time in taking a person to a smaller health unit or a primary level of hospital where they cannot do anything. अब जो भी करना है आप इतना जल्दी मतलब द टाइमिंग इज बिटवीन 6 to 8 hours. विद इन अ पीरियड ऑफ 6 to 8 hours इफ यू कैन शिफ्ट द पर्सन अलॉन्ग विद द कट फिंगर टू अ हॉस्पिटल वेयर द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ प्लास्टिक सर्जन या वैस्कुलर सर्जन ये रहना है. इवन इन अवर हॉस्पिटल वी डोंट हैव द फैसिलिटी ऑफ द वैस्कुलर सर्जन हियर और प्लास्टिक सर्जन. सो बेटर यू कैन यू हैव टू टेक द पर्सन टू अ कॉर्पोरेट हॉस्पिटल वेयर द रेलवे टाई अप इज देयर. And later you can give a memo or a letter from your department to the concerned railway hospital where the doctor will endorse it. So aap itna jaldi karne se aapko chances hai jo bhi you can have the chance of getting back the finger to the person. And the surgery is also not an easy one because you have to do it under microscope where the vein will be connected to the vein, artery will be connected to the artery, and it cannot be done by an ordinary surgeon. So the availability of plastic surgeon or the vascular surgeon should always be warranted. So next we will go on to the electric shock. So electric shock mein kya karenge? You know that there is a circuit going on where the from the mains to the person who has got affected. So you have to break the circuit either by switching off the mains if it is nearby, or you can push the person away from the source of contact. For pushing, what you will do, you can either use some plastic non-conductor. Don't use any metal, or don't touch him also because you can also get affected. So push him away with a wooden stick or something. And after he's removed, you go check the person. You go check the person whether he has got signs of life. अगर वो ब्रीदिंग है, हार्ट बीट है, पहले क्या वी हैव सीन द स्टार्ट ऑफ द क्लास हाउ विल यू चेक फॉर द हार्ट बीट एंड ब्रीदिंग, ऐसा चेक करना पड़ेगा. अगर ब्रीदिंग साइंस नहीं है तो इमीडिएटली स्टार्ट गिविंग सीपीआर. इफ ही इज ओके, इफ ही इज कॉन्शियस एंड बट ही इज लिटिल बिट टायर्ड एंड जो बट ही इज टॉकिंग टू यू, देन डोंट वरी बिकॉज टॉकिंग पर्सन हैज गॉट हिज लंग्स एंड हार्ट नॉर्मल फंक्शनिंग. सो डोंट गिव सीपीआर टू अ पर्सन हु इज टॉकिंग. ओके, so you ask him, you tell him, don't worry, we are all here. Again take him to the hospital, nearby hospital, where the doctor takes ECG for all electric shock patients. Why ECG has to be taken? Because electric shock can alter the electrical activity of the heart itself. So the person can have irregular heartbeat in the heart level. which can be picked out by using a by checking the ECG. So all electric shock patients in hospital, we will take an ECG, and everything is okay, we will give some treatment, and he can be sent home. Then what is the treatment for fits or seizures? So the person throws fits. So what is the cause for fits? As I told you, any head injury can cause fits. A person who is having family history, suppose the fits can be happening in the family, like a mother or father can have fits, the child can also have fits. A certain fits runs in families also. And other thing is, some the electrical activity, the brain is altered, the person gets a fit. So what will you do when a person is having active fits? Yeah, we all have seen in the movies also giving some keys, iron keys. So iron something you can give. That is actually as a practice. But nowhere in the medical books it is given. So it is not scientifically proven. Even if you give keys or even if you give iron rods, if you don't give, the fits will come down in a period of 3 to 5 minutes maximum. So only thing is, you have to make some space around him. So don't make a crowd. So he has to breathe normally. So make a space around him, let him breathe normally, remove objects around so that he doesn't get injured. And one thing is, the possibility is he can bite his own tongue. So aapko, if you have a small rubber or a wooden thing or something, you can keep in between the two jaws so that he does not bite his own tongue. This is the only precautions you have to do. Otherwise, no further treatment is necessary. Most of the fits will come down in a matter of 3 to 5 minutes. So when after the fits come down, you can call the ambulance. A person can be shifted to the hospital where we take CT scan of the brain and EEG. EEG is electroencephalogram. EEG for the brain activity. All these tests will be done and the treatment will be started. Another important cause of fits is a person heavily alcohol. If a person is taking alcohol continuously and he stops for 2-3 days, he gets something called withdrawal fits. So next, moving on to some insect bites. So bee stings are dangerous or not? But not, yeah, they're not very dangerous, but some people then they can become allergic to the sting venom. So they can become hypotension, that the blood pressure may fall. The blood pressure may fall and they may even develop some shock state. So in that case, we have to give some IV fluids, glucose dena padega, thoda BP badhne ke liye. And apart from this, what is the first aid measure for bee sting? You see something called a stinger. Stinger is a fiber like hota hai, wo jo bhi sting hone ke site pe. So you have to remove that stinger using a plucker or any flat object. Again, don't use your hand to remove it. Remove karne ke baad, wash the area with the soap and running water. And you can apply something called, something like a base, any base like chunna you can apply or toothpaste. Because all these insect venoms are acidic in nature. So kuch bhi basic hai, aap thoda wo apply kar sakte. Even soap is also basic. So you wash the area with soap and running water and you can apply it like a chunna or a toothpaste. These are all basic things. So acid-based neutralization ho jayega. This is the first aid you can give. And later for the pain ke liye kuch to kuch karke, you can even get a consultation from the doctor. Next is snake bite. Yeah, almost most of the snakes are poisonous. As you say, this is a cobra snake. So is it necessary that your person should know which snake has bitten him? Yes, because each snake has got different toxicity. Matlab kya hai, cobra bite hone se what system will get affected? It is a neurotoxin. So the nervous system gets affected in cobra bite. Other poisonous snakes are, say, especially in India, we have viper. Viper is nothing but you have spectacles. Spectacles like round appearance on the body. That is called viper. Viper bite hone ke baad kya hota hai? The person will have something called hemotoxicity. That is, the blood gets affected and the clotting system gets affected. He starts bleeding everywhere. Clotting nahi hota hai. Isiliye the bleeding, he starts bleeding from the eyes, from the skin. So this is the effect of viper bite. So what is the first aid treatment for snake bite? So we all know. So when there is a snake bite in one area, you have to observe for this bite mark. Usually there'll be two bite marks, and above that area, say about 2 to 3 inches or above, you have to put a bandage around that, about that place, so that the venom does not go inside the body. Okay, it should be just tight. Don't make it so tight so that the blood supply that part of the limb gets, it requires some blood also. Blood aana padega. Isliye itna tight nahi karna hai, thoda tight hona hai, so that venom does not go inside the body. So karne ke baad itna jaldi aap nearby government hospital ko transport karna hai. Kyon government hospital? All government hospitals will have treatment for the snake bite. So what is the treatment for snake bite? We give something called anti-snake venom, ASV. So anti-snake venom, snake ka venom andar body ka andar hai, so you give something for neutralizing it. So anti-snake venom dete hai. So this will be available in all government hospitals. So shift them as early as possible to a nearby hospital. One precaution is, snake ka dusra kuch treatment ka kuch farak nahi hota hai. See, the treatment for snake bite is ASV, irrespective of cobra bite or viper bite or crate bite. All these snakes will have the same treatment. Snake bites will have the same treatment, that is anti-snake venom, because it is polyvalent. Lekin cobra bite hone ke liye neurotoxic hota hai. So the person will have decreased mentation. He will feel sleepy, he will feel drowsy. So aap transport karne ke samay, make him stay alert and awake. Keep talking to him. Don't allow him to sleep at all. So that is the, and even hospital also, we will monitor the nervous system of the person. The doctor knows that it is a cobra bite. And viper bite, the doctor knows it is a viper bite, he will monitor the clotting system of the person. He will see the clotting time every day, so that he will know whether the treatment is effective or not. So actually I come from south of Tamil Nadu. I am from Madurai. So I studied from government Rajaji hospitals, the government hospital, state government hospital, where we get almost every day snake bite cases. And the patients, they are from the in around the villages of the Madurai city, and they kill the snake, and they bring the killed snake in a basket to show to the doctor what type of snake it is, so that we will identify it and we'll monitor the system. Treatment ke wajah se kuch farak nahi hota hai, lekin humko monitoring ke liye itna helpful hota hai, we will know which system to monitor for that particular patient. So this one I want to tell, because even though the people are little bit less educated in that area, they know the importance of knowing which snake has bitten that person, and they will come and tell to the doctor also.
Excuse me, madam.
Yes.
Madam, in case after biting the snake missing, and we cannot see him or catch him, then what to do?
Yeah, suppose that is called unknown bite. Oh, humko pata nahi hai whether it is poisonous snake or non-poisonous snake. Humko pata nahi hai wo snake hai ya dusra kuch insect hota hai. Lekin we call it as unknown bite. Aisa condition mein kya karenge? We will admit the person, we will keep the person under observation for 48 hours. We will do all the testing karenge. Oh, agar snake bite mein to testing mein pata chalega. Bleeding time agar jyada hai to it may be because of snake. And we will also see the bite mark. Bite mark agar do hota to we will take it as a snake bite. Patient ka condition, clinical response deke hum treatment shuru karenge. So it's, we call it as unknown. We will admit the person as unknown bite, and we will, as per the response of the person and other features, investigations, we will start the treatment.
Madam.
Yeah. Any other doubts? Yeah. Told you can get the person immediate help, and this place to keep the bitten area below the level of the heart of the person, and give him some mental support, because jo bhi snake bite ho raha hai wo patient ko he almost thinks he is going to die. Itna fear aata hai that he is going to die. So just give him some mental support, tell him nothing will happen, we are all here. आपको अच्छा ट्रीटमेंट देंगे, यू विल नॉट डाई. कुछ अच्छा वर्ड्स बोल के यू हैव टू बूस्ट अप दिस mental confidence. Next is rabies. Rabies hai to kya hai? It's a viral disease. It occurs because of dog bite. Not only dog bite, what are the other animals which can cause rabies? Yeah, it's as you see here, cats, bats. It is very common in Western countries, even though it is not that much in India. In US, bat bites are very common. Rats can also transmit rabies. Monkeys can also transmit. So all these animals can cause rabies. So any of these animals bite, we will give the rabies vaccine. So what is the first aid treatment for any animal bite? Dog bite, jo bhi hai, dog bite, cat bite, rat bite. First and foremost step is wash the wound. Wash the wound not once, at least 3 to 4 times. You wash the wound with running water and soap. Soap bhi apply karna hai, because rabies virus is a very mild virus. आप इतना अच्छी आप फर्स्ट एड ट्रीटमेंट दे रहे हो, यू विल दैट वायरस विल गेट किल्ड ऑफ. एंड दिस इज वन वुंड विच यू शुड नॉट अप्लाई एनी ड्रेसिंग अप्लाई करने की जरूरत नहीं. एंड कीप द वुंड ओपन, बिकॉज ऑन एक्सपोजर टू द एयर दैट वायरस विल डाई आउट. इफ यू कवर द वुंड, द वायरस विल स्टार्ट एंटरिंग इन साइड द बॉडी. सो यू ऑलवेज कीप द वुंड ओपन एंड गो रश टू द हॉस्पिटल वेर दे गिव रेबीज वैक्सीन. हाउ मेनी डोजेस ऑफ रेबीज वैक्सीन शुड बी गिवन? Five doses should be given. Sometimes the dog is a pet dog. Agar pet dog ko pura inka bhi vaccination pura de diye to you can stop with 3. And the doctor also tells you wash the dog for 10 days. Why 10 days? In 10 days, if the dog is still alive, that means it is not infected with rabies. Matlab kya hai? Agar 10 days ka andar the dog has died, then it has got infection of rabies. You have to take full precautions. Jo bhi advice hospital ka advice de rahe ho, pura follow karna hai. If the dog is alive even after 10 days, you need not have to worry about it. Agar dog trace nahi karte ho, to we have to take full 5 doses. If the street dog aapko iske baad aapko kuch dekhne ke liye nahi hai, to then you have to take all full 5 courses. So this is the treatment or the first aid or for the any dog bite or cat or any animal bite. Yes. Yes. Clear nahi.
Dog ke dead karne ka kya karan hota hai?
Inka rabies hone ke samay the dog cannot live for more than 10 days. Inka life itna hi hai. Rabies virus infection aane ke baad dog ka life span hai to only 10 days. It cannot live beyond 10 days. इसीलिए वो रैपिड डॉग
नहीं है, मतलब रैबिट नहीं है उसमें.
नहीं है तो इट कैन लिव 10 डेज के बाद भी वो इट विल बी अलाइव. मालूम होता है कि द डॉग इज स्टिल अलाइव, सो इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी रेबीज. आपको थोड़ा एक क्लू है.
ओके,
सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस, सपोज अ पर्सन हैज नेग्लेक्टेड टेकिंग वैक्सीन, मतलब वो सोचे कि कुछ नहीं होता है, आई विल नॉट, ही डिड नॉट गो टू हॉस्पिटल. से आफ्टर a few weeks the person develops symptoms of rabies. Symptoms of rabies hai to kya hota hai? He will have fever. Of course fever will be there, starting with fever, and he will have all signs of phobia. Phobia hai to kya hai? Excessive fear, jada so it is, some amount of fear is normal. All of us will have little amount of fear for each something, that is normal. When the fear is excessive and it is impractical, jada मतलब द पर्सन विल हैव सो मच ऑफ फियर फॉर इवन सिंपल थिंग्स लाइक वाटर, दैट्स कॉल्ड हाइड्रोफोबिया. फॉर लाइट, दैट्स कॉल्ड फोटोफोबिया. सो ही विल आइसोलेट हिमसेल्फ इन अ डार्क रूम एंड ही विल नॉट कम आउटसाइड, एंड इन अ लेटर स्टेज ही विल स्टार्ट बिहेविंग लाइक अ मैड. सो मैडनेस होता है. सो कंडीशन में, इस पोजिशन में द पर्सन इज टेकन टू द हॉस्पिटल, वॉट इज द ट्रीटमेंट? देर इज नो ट्रीटमेंट. रेबीज, वंस इट कम्स, इट इज 100% डेथ. There is no treatment at all. What they will do, the hospital authorities, they will put him in a separate cell, or it's like a jail. It's called rabies cell. There he is allowed to die without, they will not give water, they will not give food. In a dark area they will put, and he will allowed to die. This is the treatment for rabies. That means that there is no, this is the ultimate destination of rabies. Such a cruel disease, but be easily prevented by taking vaccine. That's why Government of India is taking so much of effort to take all precautions that the awareness to create among the public that once a person gets a dog bite, you have to take a rabies vaccine to prevent rabies happening, occurring. Because once rabies sets in, there is no treatment. Is it clear? Yes. So coming to the last, coming to the last topic, this is about triaging. As you see, what is triage? First, second, third, last. What you see in the slide is first, second, third, and last. Means, suppose there is a mass casualty. Say, for example, a train accident or a train derailment where so many people are having have got injured and they require emergency help or first aid measures. You go as a team of rescue members. The order of priority for whom you will give treatment first. That is called triaging. As you see, there are different colors. The first you have to give treatment to, that is comes under red. Second is yellow. Third is again green. So they have color codes also. I'll give you a hypothetical situation. Like as a train derailment or train accident has happened and you go to the spot of accident and you see different people. You go see a child, that is A, take it as A. The child has got injuries in the forehead, small abrasion or bruise as we saw the type of wound, small injury on the forehead, and it has got separated from the parents and it's crying, sitting alone. That is A. You go see another person, B. He has got a deep cut injury in the neck and he is bleeding so much. Already he has lost almost 1 liter of blood around. You see blood all around and he's almost gasping. That is B. Within 5 days, you go and see another person, C. He has got something like an open fracture. What we saw, he has got an open fracture in the leg. He's also bleeding and he's almost crying out of pain because he's got so much of pain and the bone is also coming out and you are seeing that person over there. That is C. Next, you go to another person, D. Where he's almost gasping, but you don't see any bleeding or any injury outside, but he's having difficulty in breathing and he's also in danger. So what is your order of preference? Whom you will give treatment or first aid first? I want some of you to answer.
Specific way to help the virus succeed.
Yes. Medicine has made a lot of progress. Last one, somebody has written last one. Fact, so D. I can hear many D's. Several weeks before you get symptoms. Anybody else wants to tell any other answer?
But once those symptoms develop, that virus has made its way into your brain, and at that point.
Yeah, many. One person has come with C. So you all know that. Why not A and B? You know that A is a minor injury. The child, you do not have to do anything. You can just give some biscuit or chocolate, do some, that is not necessary because it's not bleeding at all. Just make her sit there and later you can reunite the child with the parents. See, I told you the B and D are dangerous. You think that B is also going to die and D is also going to die. They both are gasping and anytime they both can die.
Hello.
So you have a dilemma to go between B and D. The answer is D. As you all said, many have said the answer is D and not B. Why not B? Because as I told you, that person has got a deep cut in the neck and he has already lost so much of. ठीक है हिंदी में बोलना है. B और D के बीच में आपको थोड़ा doubt है. B का के तो क्या है? Has got deep neck injury है. ज़्यादा blood खून भी निकाला है. So he has already lost so much of blood. वो भी gasping है. जो भी आप उधर कर सकते हैं, you are not going to save his life. You cannot save him. But D, at the same time, आप D के पास जाके कुछ तो कुछ first aid करने से, you have chance that you can save his life. So here the answer is D. D है तो first आना है. इसके बाद C आना है. C ये तो क्या है? Again, he is also having some bleeding and everything. So you put some first aid measure. आपको थोड़ा shift करना है hospital को. So ambulance को shift करना है C. Then comes B and A. B and A are least. इनका B का क्या करना है? कुछ भी नहीं करना है. You just have to give respect to the dying person. कुछ भी नहीं करना है. So according to this, you have three categories. Category one में क्या आता है? highest priority for immediate help. This is D. Category 2 may lowest priority. People with minor injuries like the child A, people or people who will almost certainly die, like E. ये दोनों लोएस्ट कैटेगरी में आता है. यू नीड नॉट हैव टू गिव अटेंशन टू देम. नेक्स्ट इज कैटेगरी 3, हु नीड्स फर्स्ट एड. ही कम्स अंडर सी. दिस इज कॉल्ड ट्राइएजिंग. यू कैन वेट सेफली फॉर सर्जरी. इनका भी कुतरा करना है लेकिन यू कैन गिव सम टाइम. सो फॉर ऑर्डर ऑफ प्रेफरेंस फॉर अवर केस इज डी फर्स्ट, नेक्स्ट कम्स सी, सी एंड ए आर लीस्ट. बट कैटेगरी में आता है. मींस सेकंड इज नंबर सेकंड. यस
मैडम, गैस्पिंग क्यों होता है? व्हाई गैस्पिंग इज अफेक्टेड?
गैस्पिंग है तो ही इज ऑलमोस्ट इन द लास्ट स्टेज. मतलब वो कुछ हेड इंजरी होने के चांसेस है लेकिन बाहर है तो कुछ नहीं दिख रहे. बी बी में क्या हुआ है? इनका नेक कट हो गया है एंड ऑलरेडी ही हैज ब्लेड सो मच. ही इज इन द लास्ट फाइनल मिनट्स. अब जो भी कर सकते हो, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू सेव हिज लाइफ. बट एट द सेम टाइम इफ यू फॉर अ पर्सन लाइक डी, इनका आपको मालूम नहीं हुआ है क्यों इनका गैस्पिंग हो रहा है लेकिन इनका इंजुरी से तो बाहर कुछ नहीं दिख रहे, लेकिन कुछ नहीं है, इंटरनल इंजुरी कुछ के चांसेस है. बट यू हैव टू गिव द चांस फॉर लाइक अ डी. द सेम टाइम इफ यू गिव द टाइम फॉर अ पर्सन लाइक डी, देयर इज चांस दैट यू कैन सेव हिज लाइफ. लेकिन बी का है तो इतना ब्लड लॉस हो गया है, आप ट्रैक के पास कुछ भी नहीं कर सकते हैं. तो आप इनका लाइफ सेव करने के लिए, सो ही कम्स अंडर लोएस्ट कैटेगरी. This is the lowest priority, that is category 2. People who will almost certainly die. But your immune system doesn't see. C ka kya hua hai? Highest priority for immediate help. So this is this person ko immediate jaldi kuch karke you can shift him and take some treatment, you give some find out what is the reason for that gasping. Wo head injury hone ke liye unconscious ho raha hai, iska bhi gasping hota hai. So you have to find out what is the cause. Ab kuch kuch immediate surgery, kuch head injury hua to kuch immediate ka hospital shift karke kuch craniotomy immediate surgery karne se the chances hai that he will survive. Lekin B ka ऐसा नहीं है, इसीलिए द डी शुड बी गिवन अटेंशन मोर देन. The virus replicates in the brain, it starts to mess with the brain's cellular proteins, causing neural dysfunction. This is where certain symptoms of rabies start and how you can tell the infection has fully set in. Doubts hai? Once the infection, I think you must be having so many doubts. Another 15 minutes hai, aap doubts pooch sakte hain.
Ye madam aapne bola tha cardiac arrest mein kya dispirin dene ke liye bola tha. हाँ, था ना? Excuse me?
कार्डियक अरेस्ट में नहीं है, हार्ट अटैक में देना है. हार्ट अटैक और कार्डियक अरेस्ट का फर्क क्या है? हार्ट अटैक में पेशेंट कॉन्शियस होता है एंड ही विल टेल दैट आई एम हैविंग चेस्ट पेन. वो पूरा स्वेटिंग आता है, पेन हो रहा है, कुछ बोलते हैं, वो पेशेंट को आप डिस्प्रिन और एस्प्रिन दे सकते हैं. कार्डियक अरेस्ट में क्या होता है, पेशेंट विल नॉट बी कॉन्शियस एट ऑल, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन ही विल कोलैप्स. आप बात नहीं करते हैं, कुछ भी नहीं करते हैं. Almost he will become unconscious, almost he will die, he is almost dying. उस condition में आप CPR देना है, cardiac arrest में CPR देना है. आप
अच्छा उनको ये वो मतलब ये chest को भी ये करना है ना, press करना है
chest को,
press मतलब दबाना है.
CPR दबाना बोलना नहीं, मेरा class के बाद आप जो बोलना है CPR बोलना है, ठीक है? CPR तो क्या है, cardiopulmonary resuscitation है. मेरा पहले स्लाइड से थोड़ा वो देख लीजिए, मैं शेयर करूँ मैं. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड CPR. CPR करने में चेस्ट कंप्रेशन करना है. अगर कार्डियक अरेस्ट में पेशेंट का पहले तो यू चेक फॉर ब्रीदिंग चेक करना है, हार्ट बीट चेक करना है. वो दोनों नहीं है तो आप जल्दी CPR शुरू करना है. CPR में क्या है, चेस्ट कंप्रेशन आउट, माउथ टू माउथ ब्रीदिंग, ये दोनों अल्टरनेट करके देना है.
मैडम गुड मॉर्निंग.
गुड मॉर्निंग
मैडम. सपोज किसी के एक्सीडेंट होता है और इमीडिएटली वो पानी मांगता है, तो उनको पानी देना चाहिए उस समय?
ये अच्छा क्वेश्चन है, क्योंकि हेड इंजरी होने के समय वो पेशेंट को अगर ऑपरेशन करने के लिए चांस है तो आप पानी ज्यादा नहीं देना है, क्योंकि फास्टिंग पे रहना है सर्जरी के पहले. इसलिए आप पूछ रहे तो थोड़ा ओनली 2-3 स्पून ऑफ वाटर दे सकते हैं, इसके ऊपर नहीं देना है.
अगर मैडम हेड इंजरी ना हो तो सिंपली अगर किसी के और किसी जगह ब्लीडिंग हो रहा है जैसे नोज में ब्लीडिंग हो रहा है और माउथ से ब्लीडिंग हो रहा है और
दे सकते हैं हेड इंजरी केसेस को अगर ऑपरेशन के लेने के चांसेस है तो आप पानी नहीं देना है क्योंकि ऑपरेशन लेने से पहले पेशेंट है तो फास्टिंग पे होना है
ओके मैम थैंक यू
Why fasting is required for operation?
पानी दीजिए इस कंडीशन में पानी दे सकते हैं
नहीं इस कंडीशन में
पानी दे सकते हैं वाटर दे सकते हैं उनको अगर वो मैसी ही और सी सिक्स आई गिव सम वाटर फॉर माय थर्स्ट कैन आई गिव द वाटर
यू कैन गिव बट नॉट सो मच ओनली टू स्पून्स और थोड़ा एक बॉटल का जो भी है वो ऊपर का कैप से दे सकते हैं You cannot make him drink so much of water. क्या होता है why somebody has asked me some question why fasting is required before operation. Operation के समय anesthetic drugs देते हैं ना so that will produce some vomiting.
Yes.
Vomiting so stomach है तो empty रहना है अगर stomach में कुछ पानी कुछ है तो vomiting करके aspirate होने के chances है इसीलिए the person will be in fasting before taking for any operation.
अगर मैडम operation ना हो simply case में अगर कोई अनकॉन्शियसनेस हो जा रहा है कोई किसी की वो थोड़ा सीवियरली एक्सीडेंट हो गया वो पानी रिक्वायर कर रहे हैं अगर हम ग्लास ऑफ वाटर देते हैं उसमें क्या रिपरकशन आएगा
नहीं अनकॉन्शियस पेशेंट को कुछ भी नहीं देना है दैट इज माय आई टोल्ड यू दैट इज माय टेक होम मैसेज अगर पेशेंट बेहोश में नहीं है तो आप मुंह से कुछ भी नहीं देना है पानी नहीं देना है कुछ भी नहीं देना है अगर पेशेंट कॉन्शियस है वो मांग रहे आई एम थर्स्टी यू गिव मी गिव सम वाटर है तो देन आप दो आप थोड़ा वाटर दे सकते हैं क्योंकि आपको
नहीं, अगर मैडम वो अगर मैडम वो सर्जरी ना हो अगर सर्जरी ना हो उनको जरूर चांसेस ऑफ सर्जरी ना
दे सकते हैं वाटर दे सकते हैं
और मैडम अनकॉन्शियस समय में देने में क्या फर्क पड़ेगा अगर
अनकॉन्शियस
है
कुछ मुंह से दिए तो क्या होता है वाटर कैन एंटर इनटू द लंग्स बिकॉज़ इनका स्वॉलिंग नॉर्मल नहीं होता है ना अनकॉन्शियस पेशेंट को स्वॉलिंग नहीं होता है सो आप जो भी वाटर पोर कर रहे हैं वो कैन गो इनटू द विंड पाइप वो आप कुछ डेंजर कर रहे हैं इनका हेल्प नहीं कर रहे सो अनकॉन्शियस पेशेंट को मुंह से कुछ भी नहीं देना है सो हाउ मेनी आवर्स ऑफ लाइफ कैन ही सर्वाइव आफ्टर स्नेक बाइट एक क्वेश्चन आया कि हाउ मेनी आवर्स ऑफ लाइफ कैन अ पर्सन सर्वाइव आफ्टर स्नेक बाइट वो डिपेंड्स ऑन द टाइप ऑफ स्नेक एंड कहाँ काटे वो सो सपोज द स्नेक बाइट इज हैपनिंग नियर द ट्रंक नेक उसमें जल्दी हो जाएगा अब जो भी करने के भी चांसेस नहीं होता है अगर लिम्स हैंड्स फीट में होता है तो द चांसेस ऑफ सर्वाइवल इज बेटर और इतना जल्दी ट्रांसपोर्ट कर रहे हो एंड द एज ऑफ द स्नेक वो एज छोटा स्नेक है तो द यंग स्नेक हैज गॉट लेस अमाउंट ऑफ वेनम सो डिपेंड्स ऑन द एज ऑफ द स्नेक हाउ मच ऑफ वेनम इट हैज गॉन इनटू द बॉडी डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स है So it is not a single factor. It depends on the type of the snake, कहाँ काटे वो. So इतना factors है decide करने के लिए.
Excuse me, madam.
Yeah.
Madam, in case of rabies, yes. Sometimes it happens that instead of biting, the dog or cat gives a scratch by its nail to the limbs, or say feet or hand. So in that case also rabies protection must be given.
Yeah, it should be given because we classify the injuries as class 1, class 2, class 3. Class 1 is superficial scratches. Kuch nail se kuch scratch ho gaya hai. Lick ki hai, dog a lick but not in the skin but in the, suppose you have got a wound already and the dog licks over it. Oh, jo bhi aap rabies vaccine lena hai. So even licks or scratches. नेल्स के स्क्रैच हो रहा तो भी पैसा लेना है बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट टेक रिस्क एंड एल्स इज आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन लाइक व्हाट यू डू फॉर रेबीज गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल ओनली ऑप्शन नो द प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल इज द रेबीज वैक्सीन इज मे बी अवेलेबल इन ऑल द प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स ऑल्सो सो यू कैन टेक ट्रीटमेंट फ्रॉम एनीवेयर I could say some other question like the questions have repeated,
ma'am. Ma'am, in case of arsenic bite, if arsenic is available at that site, we should kill them and take along with the hospital, or should remain alive.
First, you are asking?
Yes, ma'am.
Snake bite?
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah.
Snake bite. It's always better that you take him to a government hospital, because all government hospital treatment for snake bite. Anti-snake venom will be available. And the killed, if you have seen the snake and it, better to take the snake also to for the doctor to identify the snake, so that we will know which system treatment ke liye kuch farak nahi hota hai. As I told you, anti-snake venom is a polyvalent. Matlab, either it's a cobra bite or viper bite, the treatment is the same. आप विच सिस्टम मॉनिटर करना है उसमें फर्क आता है.
ओके, एक्चुअली मैम बहुत जगह ये बोला जाता है ना कि स्नेक बाइट करने के बाद वो स्नेक को नहीं मारना चाहिए, शुड नॉट बी किल्ड. तो
ना, यू नॉट kill the snake, but the thing is, if you have taken a picture or something, you should know, or you can come and tell that it is a cobra snake to the doctor. So doctor ko malum padna hai ki whether the snake is a type of snake it is.
Okay.
Excuse me.
I see question. Yes.
Madam, one doubt is there. Here one such incident happened. One school child, nursery child, he at the time of playing with puppies, small puppies, he got scratches of nails in his feet. But due to some reasons, maybe getting scolded by his parents, he suppressed the fact. And later the boy, after some time, he died. So in this case what to do, madam? Is there, because baby, a small child, due to getting scolded by his parents, he may suppress the fact and don't tell his, after coming from school, he or she may not tell his parents that I got scratches. He actually, the case happened, he told his parents that due to some other reason he has got abrasions, but he did not tell that while playing with the puppy he gets scratched, and that is the reason he died. So in this case, any suggestion from your end, madam?
No, that is why the syllabus also, this is included in the syllabus, children's syllabus, because they also should be aware any dog bite can cause something called rabies, and which can be easily prevented. Even in children's school syllabus also, it is included in science textbook. I have seen so many lessons about this dog bite and rabies and everything. So government should actually, it is an awareness. Even the parents giving awareness to the children, or government giving awareness in the form of pamphlets and TV ads. So everybody should get awareness, because it is easily preventable, but because of ignorance, they lose their life. Somebody was asking about scorpion bite. Yeah, scorpion bite is again dangerous one, because scorpion bite is venomous, and the scorpion bite will be, what measures to be taken, the same all insect bites are acidic. So now wash the area with soap and running water, apply some chuna, and immediately rush to the hospital. We will give some anesthetic agents, local anesthetic. Suppose that person has got injury in the hand, we will anesthetize around, we'll give some injections around so that the pain will come down. And again, in a scorpion bite, take an ECG also, and we will keep the person under observation for at least a period of 24 hours.
Ma'am, in case of dog bite, how many time we have for first dose?
How many times you have to take the injections?
Yeah.
Five doses you have to take, starting from the day of bite, 3, 7, 14 and 28. These are the days. The doctor will advise you next to come on. So minimum five injections you have to take it.
Ma'am, actually, मतलब जब dog जब वो bite करता है ma'am, तो first dose हम मतलब कितना जल्दी उसको देना चाहिए ये मैं पूछा मतलब पहला dose पहला injection जो है वो कितने घंटे
का देना चाहिए? Preferably within 24 hours. 24 hours को अंदर देना है.
Okay, okay.
And somebody asked, how can you prevent tension and hypertension? Tension, I think it's more of stress. Hypertension, it is a high blood pressure. High blood pressure, ka, what is it? Yes?
Bun condition, we can give it water or not bun condition?
Dog bite ke liye, they...
Koi aadmi bun ho gaya hai.
Snake bite, nahin, burns ka, de sakte hai. Agar operation ka kuch chances hai, toh unka, wo patient... उसको नहीं दे कि सबको पानी दे सकते हैं फॉर डॉग बाइट स्नेक बर्न्स सबको दे सकते हैं सो प्रिवेंट टेंशन एंड हाइपरटेंशन दैट्स वन क्वेश्चन पुट बाय अनबासी सो हाइपरटेंशन है तो हाई ब्लड प्रेशर है हाई ब्लड प्रेशर क्यों होता है फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट कल्प्रिट इज सॉल्ट सो सॉल्ट कम करना है ये तो इवन बिकॉज ऑफ अवर वर्क टेंशन स्ट्रेस के लिए भी हाइपरटेंशन होता है सो वी हैव टू डू सम मेडिटेशन एंड प्रेयर्स टू माइंड इसके साथ यू हैव टू कीप अ रेगुलर चेक एवरी सिक्स मंथ आप ब्लड प्रेशर चेक करना है इफ यू आर अबव 35 और 40 ईयर्स एंड सॉल्ट इनटेक
ओके
अब जो भी सॉल्ट ज़्यादा है जो स्नैक अवॉइड करना है लाइक पिकल्स Pickles has got maximum amount of salt. Pickles and the chips, all those things will contain so much of salt. So junk foods bhi avoid karna hai. And adequate sleep. Sleep is also very much necessary for preventing hypertension.
Madam, excuse me, madam.
Yes.
Madam, in case of any accident, if a patient who is who has to get operation, if somebody unknowingly gives him water because some crowd in crowds, somebody he may not yes. know, he gives more water, then the operation cannot take place or doctors can extract water no. from the stomach.
Yeah, we will do that. We will. Yeah, what we will do is we will put a tube into the stomach and we'll take the water out. We will send the person for surgery. So no more doubts?
No, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, thank you. Why heart attack comes? One more last question I will take it. That's why heart attack comes. As I told you, the heart, the blood supply, heart ka jo bhi hai, the heart also requires some blood for its action. Oh, block hone, clot hota hai, the blood vessel will be occluded with a clot. That will cause heart attack. So, oh, clot hone ke karan kya hai? The first and foremost is family. Agar aapka family pay, especially your father or your brother, somebody has died because of heart attack before the age of 50. Aapka bhi risk jata. So family history is more first and foremost important, which you cannot change at all. So that reason for early deaths. Matlab 40, 35 years mein, 40 years mein bhi heart attack aata hai. History, they may be a father would have died because of heart attack before the age of 50 or 55 years. Family history is first and foremost. Second is high blood pressure. When sugar is high, again you have risk of diabetic pain, risk of heart attack. And the other thing is cholesterol. So cholesterol diet, that can also cause heart attack. So these all help make the forming clots easier. So these are the risk factors of heart attack. So for a healthy life, you have to go regular exercise, at least 30 to 40 or 45 minutes per day, at least for 5 days a week, minimum is week, and avoid junk foods, have regular at the interval of 3 to 4 hours, natural food as much as possible, and adequate sleep, avoid tension and stress. So these are the, reduce the oil intake. Oil is very, very important. Reduce the oil intake to only 4 spoons per day for a person. So these are the ways how we can prevent heart attack. Having a regular checkup also. Depending on the area of the brain, the person can have either a paralysis of, or he may become speechless. So this is called brain stroke. So, but the reason is the same. Happens in the
brain hemorrhage.
How long can antivenom be stored? There's always a expiry date for all the medicines, including anti-snake venom, rabies, everything. So that will be written over the vial. They'll be stored in the refrigerator. Antivenom will be stored in the refrigerator. That's again question which I got from SK Gupta. Gas and heart attack.
गैस प्रॉब्लम के लिए कोई ट्रीटमेंट?
गैस प्रॉब्लम के लिए आपका अगेन वो द सेम, आपको यू हैव टू अवॉइड स्पाइसी फूड्स, टेक फूड एट रेगुलर इंटरवल्स. आप ज्यादा फास्टना है, ब्रेकफास्ट है तो यू हैव टू टेक इट एटलीस्ट बिफोर बिटवीन 9 to 10. लंच है तो 1 के अंदर लेना है, एंड हैव योर डिनर एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल बिफोर 7 o'clock. आपको स्लीप का, बिफोर यू गो टू स्लीप एटलीस्ट 2 to 3 hours गैप रहना है, एंड अवॉइड स्पाइसी, ऑयली, सॉल्टी फूड. कंटिन्यूअस नोज ब्लॉकेज. आई यू हैव टू कंसल्ट एन ईएनटी डॉक्टर फ्रॉम उर्मिशा. आपको रिपीट एवेल्युएशन चेक करना पड़ेगा. अभी इसमें बोलने के मुश्किल होता है. या end the class. Yeah, thank you. I'll share the slides with your course director. You can get it from your course director in the WhatsApp group. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.